Good evening, everyone. I'm Sir Jackson. Stay blessed as I share the word of God with you people. As I take my text from the book of Mark, as I'm beginning to read from chapter 3, verse 1. And he entered again into the synagogue, and there was a man there which had a withered hand. And they watched him, whether he would heal him on the Sabbath day, that they might accuse him. And he said unto the man which had the withered hand, Stand forth. And he said unto them, Is it lawful to do good on the Sabbath days, or to do evil, to save life, or to kill? But they held their peace. So these Pharisees were standing by on the Sabbath day when Jesus was about to heal this man from his infirmities. They were standing watching at Jesus to see whether he will heal on the Sabbath day or not. Jesus even asked them, Now you tell me, is it lawful to do good on the Sabbath day or to do evil? They held their peace. And Jesus called the man with the withered hand to stand forth. Jesus is a master healer. You might have sickness that have been in your life for a very long time. Jesus will heal you. Whatsoever sickness that you have, the master healer will heal you. Jehovah Rapha, God our healer, the master healer will heal you. And he said unto them, Is it lawful to do good on the Sabbath day or to do evil? They held their peace. And when he had looked round about on them with anger, being grieved for the hardness of their hearts, because of the tradition of these people, they don't even want Jesus to heal this man with a withered hand. They prefer the man to stay with a withered hand because of their tradition to stand. He said unto the man, Stretch forth thy hand. And he stretched it out, and his hand was restored whole as the other. Then Jesus said to the man with the withered hand, Stretch forth your hand. As soon as the man stretched forth his hand was restored back whole, like the other one. Jesus is calling you to stretch forth that your withered hand, whatsoever impotent hand, sickness, withered hand that you have, Jesus is calling you to stretch it forth, because he wants to heal you. Whatsoever sickness, whatsoever problem, Jesus is calling you to stretch it forth. because he wants to heal you. In verse 6, and the Pharisees went forth and scarcely took counsel with the Herodians against him, how they might destroy him. But Jesus withdrew himself with his disciples to the sea, and a great multitude from Galilee followed him, and from Judea, and from Jerusalem, and from Edomia, and from beyond Jordan, and there about Tyre and Sidon. Great multitude, when they heard that great thing he did, came unto him. When people saw the signs and wonders, the healing of the withered hand, and so many other miraculous signs, they followed Jesus everywhere. When they entered the temple, and they opened the book, the scroll, for him to read, they turned the part which was written in the book of Isaiah, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. That the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. For he hath anointed me to preach good tidings unto the meek. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and to opening of the prison to them that are bound. To proclaim liberty to the captives, and the opening of the prison to them which are bound. So how we went about doing good, proclaiming liberty to them which are bound. This same Jesus which I'm talking about today wants to come to you in whatever state you are. Wants you to surrender that state to him. Even if you have not made him your Lord and personal Savior, at the mention of the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess. And if you want to make him your Lord and personal Savior, he will come into your heart. He will come into your heart today. Repeat this prayer with me if you want to make Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior. And he will come and live in you and be the Lord over your life. Say, merciful Father, I repent of my sin. I asked you to come into my heart. Come and be my Lord and personal Savior. Come and live in me. Give me a new life. Thank you, Lord Jesus. In Jesus' precious name I pray. Amen. If you have said this prayer, let me pray with you. Merciful Father, come and reign in the heart of these people. Forever and ever, be their Lord and Master and Savior. Thank you, Lord. In all Lord and Masters, I ask to Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. While you are saved, find a good Bible believing church. Because the word of God, see, faith cometh by hearing, and by hearing the word of God. Stay blessed. I'm Sir Jackson. Cheers.